The Nikon D3500 is an entry-level camera with a 24.2 megapixel APS-C sensor. It was released back in 2018, making this a two-year-old camera. It can shoot 5 frames per second. It has an ISO sensitivity from 100 to 25,600. An 11.3D tracking multicam 1000 autofocus sensor module, Bluetooth connectivity, no Wi-Fi, but you can pair it with the Nikon SnapBridge app. You can also do some video work in 1080p up to 60 frames per second, battery life that lasts for days, SD card slot on the side, USB and HDMI input, built-in flash if you want to blind people, 3-inch 9-1K dot wide viewing angle TFT LCD screen on the back, and the total package weighs just 415 grams. But is this any good? What's going on, guys? Gary Yaman here, back at it again with a new video. Hope everybody's feeling safe and it's fine. Let's begin right away with reviewing this little camera right here, the entry-level Nikon DSLR D3500. Is it any good? And if you don't have the time to watch the whole video, I can now say already that this is definitely a good camera for entry-level starters, beginners, amateurs, people that want to step up from their smartphone photography, then this camera is definitely a recommendation. But if you got the time and you want to watch the whole video, we're gonna answer that question by dividing this little video in a couple of sections. First of all, the build, specs, and just the overall feeling of this camera. Secondly, we're gonna talk about the image quality. And thirdly, we're gonna talk about the performance of this camera. How does it autofocus and stuff like that. And finally, gonna talk about a little bit of some competitors' final thoughts and stuff. Let's begin right away with the overall build. It's made from plastic, lightweight, as I mentioned in the intro, 415 grams. And it literally feels like nothing, actually. What I really like about this camera is that the SD card is on the side, because that way you can just easily swap out new SD cards. The battery life of this is really good as well. Charge it beginning of the week, and then end of the week it still has like one little bar. Just the overall feel, it really feels like a sturdy camera. I don't really like the flash, and if you want to use the flash, then you can only use it like for certain circumstances if you really need it. Other than that, you can literally blind people with this little flash that pops up like so. Other things about the body that I don't really like is that it just has a fixed screen. You cannot tilt it or swivel it any way whatsoever. So that's a little bit of a bummer. So that's actually quite old school as well, right? So it's not really modern. What I also like is on the top of the camera, you got this little switch here. The live view switch, that's very handy. You can just switch very quickly and it makes that cool little sound. So that's cool, I like it. And the menu system is actually quite nice, very easy to maneuver with. And you got that little I button here that you can, that's like a fast menu thingy. And then overall, yeah, like for entry level starters, beginners, the way this camera is built, it really feels like good in the hand and it works perfectly fine. So no real complaints in that other than the flash. But in overall, for an entry level camera, the build quality is actually really good. Price here in the Netherlands, actually, it's around 400 bucks or 400 euros. And just checked it also on Amazon, it's roughly the same price in the US as well. So around 400 bucks new, but if you can get it for second hand, you can definitely check out prices from around 300 euros or $300. The Nikon F-mount lenses, there are many lenses available. I'm not even sure how many, to be honest. I like from Nikon sells, and then you got the third party options as well. So you got plenty of choices, and I think that's a great way to step in the Nikon ecosystem. Build quality, price, and like options is almost limitless. Let's talk about the image quality of this camera. I'm gonna just show you some images whilst I'm talking. I think that's the best way to show you the image quality. And as you see in those following images, it's like a variety of images. It really looks good. Even with this little kit lens, if you know how to take photos and use your settings and everything, it really works well and it really looks good. I don't have any real complaints in terms of image quality. It looks really good. Just imagine if you put a better lens on it with high glass and everything, then you can get some better images in terms of image quality. No complaints in image quality in that. The image quality for video is not like the best, but it's usable. It's almost like with this lens is like a smartphone quality, 1080p up to 60 frames per second. But test, test, test on the Nikon D3500. Look at all this crap. Can you see my crap? You know, image quality wise, it looks pretty okay. Let's put it that way. Let's talk about the performance of this camera. The performance of this camera actually surprises me. I'm gonna show you some examples, and it can actually like track on a face. It has that face priority mode, and it works a little bit, I think, for non-moving objects or when you do portrait sessions and you got a subject that just slightly moves here and there, then this is definitely a great option or a great feature. But if you do a lot of fast moving objects, fast moving things, then it doesn't like follow like real quickly, and you will lose the target quite fast as well. So you know, for an entry level camera, it performs actually really good in terms of autofocus, how it works. Even with this kit lens, it works really well. Performance wise for photo, it's not the fastest. I'm gonna put it in a little bit. I'm gonna show you what I mean with that. Let's put it in like the fast mode. It does 5 frames per second, but this is how it looks or sounds like. It's not the fastest, but I think it's quite okay, being that this is an entry-level camera. The live view mode is actually really handy, and I like using the live view mode more than using the optical viewfinder. Reason for that is that I know more that I am in focus. For instance, when I shoot somebody and using the optical viewfinder, I'm not sure if it's like focus on the face or like on the cheek or on the nose. But when you use the live view mode, then you have the face tracking on, or the face recognition on, it will lock on the face, and then you have a like more sense of knowing that the picture will be fine and that the face will be in focus. That's what I really like about this. Other than that, performance wise, for entry level camera, it works really well. So I talk about the build, image quality and performance, and I really like it so far. What I want to do as well, talk a little bit about other like competitors from Canon, for instance. A couple of weeks back, or like a month ago actually, I also had the Canon EOS 2000D Rebel T7, I believe, which is the entry level camera from Canon. The image quality is really nice, but the performance was really slow and very, very dated. This camera, the Nikon, is much faster and it feels much snappier, like faster and overall. So if you were comparing those two, the Canon EOS 2000D or this Nikon, I would suggest going for the Nikon, because that will give you like a better experience and overall. But if you put this next to, for instance, a Sony A6000, which is a mirrorless camera, then the Sony A6000 just beats this Canon in terms of performance. And image quality wise is roughly the same. I think the Sony has a little bit more advantage in terms of dynamic range, but the performance, the autofocus performance of the Sony is just much snappier, much quicker. So yeah, if I had to choose, I would choose the Sony. So final thoughts, conclusions. Do I recommend this camera for beginners, entry levels, starters, whatever? If you want to step up from your smartphone game, is this then any good? Is it still worth buying in 2020? I would say yes, a definite yes. Also, you got a lot of options in terms of lenses and all those accessories and stuff. So I think beginners will really love this camera, because it just feels like a real camera should. The overall like experience, if you are a beginner and you're going to use this camera, then you will be very happy and you will just enjoy photography. I think that's what this camera can do. All right, so I think that's it, guys. And overall, performance wise, Also, a little bit on the video as well, maybe performance-wise on the video. I didn't really talk about it, but I think performance-wise on video is actually pretty good. The autofocus works really well. Here's a little slow motion clip, and it's usable. It's usable. If you really need to use the video options of this little guy, then it's very usable. So yeah, there you have it, guys. That's all. I do recommend this camera. I had a nice time with this camera. And if you are going for it, then you know you will be very happy with it. So that's all. Thank you again for watching. Subscribe to the channel if you want to see more camera reviews. Later in the following videos, I think I will be going for a little switch from wedding photography to nature wildlife photography. There will be coming a big tele lens from Sony very soon here in my hand. So I'm very curious. I'm not a wildlife photographer, so going out of my comfort zone. Other than that, I wish you all the best. Stay safe, stay healthy. Good luck. See you in the next one.